Welcome to Trojans Live on ESPN LA 710. Tune in and live right here on Twitter. We're live inside the Galen Center, starting to fill up for the countdown to the Crosstown Showdown on the hardwood between USC and UCLA. I am Jordan Moore. I'll be on the call today. Tip time is just about an hour away. We'll fill that time from now. We'll talk to LA Times beat writers on both sides. And also Desmond Farmer, former USC. Great, but first up is assistant coach Chris Capco to give us the scouting report for today's game. We're counting down to tip-off with Mito, Swiss watches since 1918, the official timekeeper of USC Athletics. Be the first to own the Fight On limited edition timepiece. True Trojan fans, visit shopmito.com/USC. That's shopmito, MIDO.com/USC. All right, we've got Chris Capco here before he has to go to work. We're about halfway through the season. It has been an up-and-down ride. How would you characterize it so far?
I think you said it best. It's been up and down. You know, we've at times looked like a really good team and at times not so really good team. But having said that, you know, we've had three games in particular, Vanderbilt, Santa Clara, Oregon State, that have come down to the wire. And if you do a few things differently, your season looks a little bit different. So with that being said, now's the time to try to get better on both sides of the ball as we approach the stretch in our conference. Luckily, or what we've all talked about and everyone who's been associated with the league, is that the league is wide open. We believe that as well. And if we can just get better at certain things, then, you know, we feel like we're in contention to compete for a regular season and tournament championship.
UCLA has had a turbulent ride as well, as you've seen them develop and now switch to their interim coach, Murray Bartow. How have they changed?
You know, I think I don't know exactly what they've changed. I think they're playing hard, and I think ever since, and it's not a not to say anything about Coach Alford, but they just I feel like they've been playing with some energy and they've been playing hard. I think some of the noise that was around their program makes it difficult to focus at times when you're talking about coaching change and the speculation and things that come with it. Just kind of watching them from afar, I feel like they've played hard. And they've been trying to compete, and they've just been trying to go out there and leave it out there on the floor, and that's been the biggest thing.
Guy at the top of the scouting report, when you look at it, Chris Wilkes, their leading scorer, he scored in double figures in every single game, and he gave the Trojans really a hard time last year in Galen Center. He was a real key in that crucial game at the end of last season. What kind of challenges does he pose?
Yeah, I mean, he's an unbelievable shooter, a great athlete, size for the position on the wing. You know, the biggest thing, he's just made shots against us last year, and that's what we got to try to stop. In general, our three-point defense has not been good enough, especially in conference play, no matter if we won or lost. And we got to do a better job with that, and it starts with him, finding him, locating him, running him off the line, and making him take as many tough shots as we can. But what we can do is kind of let him get a rhythm like he did down the stretch last year, and then he's really tough to stop.
They are a big team, however. If you can push him out behind the arc and contest those shots, will you live with the results today?
As long as we can contest them. Yeah, I mean, that's the biggest thing is contesting and not letting their shooters get into a rhythm. And if we can do that, then we'll live with them. If people make tough shots, then you got to tip your hat off to them. Unfortunately, we haven't made enough teams take tougher threes, and that's been our issue. So just in general, it starts with Chris Wilkes, but with their team in general, they have a good shooting team. We got to make tougher shots for them. We got to make them hit tougher shots, and we can't let them get in rhythm threes and get them going.
They have great size, and it's led by their 7-foot freshman, Moses Brown. And check out this stat, Cap. I was doing some research on him. He went for 19-17 in his debut, so everyone got very excited about him. That was the best collegiate debut since a guy named Lou Alcindor for them.
Who?
Guess what he went for on his collegiate debut?
50. I'm going to say 50 and 15.
56 and 21.
Not bad. Who is that again?
I don't know who is it against.
You ever heard of him?
But I know who he became somebody pretty good. I mean, you'd be impressed if you were coaching a guy and he walked out there and got 56 and 21 on opening night. Say, okay, I'll take three more years of that.
Man, I'd be impressed if someone walked out and had 19 and 17 on opening
night. That's right. Well, Moses Brown did that 19 and 17. He's an interesting prospect, too, for them. You know, real size, good shot blocker, good rebounder. What do you guys see from him?
Yeah, I like Moses a lot, to be honest with you. I saw him a lot in high school. I'm a big fan of his. When UCLA got him, I thought he'd be great for him. He runs hard. He runs the floor hard. I think he opens up their transition. When you got a guy and you're kind of in a scramble situation and he's running the floor as hard as he does, you have to account for the basket. So now it opens up the wing and the perimeter for three-point shooters and kind of causes you to get in rotation and things like that or get into scramble situations. He, again, his size that he poses at the rim, his rebounding ability, he plays hard. I think he's going to be a heck of a player, and he's already making an impact now. And as he gets more experience, he gets stronger, he just gets better, he's going to be even more of an impact. But right now, just how hard he plays, his size and length at the rim, and what he gives him defensively more than anything. But I'm a big fan of Moses Brown.
And they are a very good rebounding team. It has been an issue at times, the defensive glass for USC this season. I mean, you can't get bigger. How much you really just talk it up and try to get your bigs to play tough today?
Yeah, outside of three-point shooting, the three-point line, defensive rebounding has been something we've tried to emphasize all year. We've tried to drill it. Our guys at some point have to make a conscious effort, though, when the shot goes up. And it's not just our big guys. People will look at it and be like, our big guy's got to block out. But our guards got to do a better job, too. Guys come from the perimeter, and we just got to find them, and we got to limit teams to one chance. And you can't be a good defensive team if you don't limit them to one opportunity. And for us to take a step defensively, we have to limit teams to one chance, and that starts with blocking out and putting a body on someone when they go to the glass.
Give me an impact player for USC today. Who do you have your eye on to see who could be the X factor for the Trojans?
To me, I don't think it's an X factor. It's Benny and Jonah got to be good for us. Our older guys just have to be good.
They've been in a lot of these battles, which helps.
They've been in a lot of these battles. They've been experienced. We'll go as far as Benny and Jonah take us. And I'll throw Nick into that. You know, I think against Oregon State, Benny was great. He's got to continue. We can't expect him to have 37 every night, but he's got to be good for us to win. I think it's going to be hard for us to win games if Benny is not good.
And what's the key to the game for you on the floor?
On the three-point line. We have to do a better job of taking care of it. If you look at the game and we look at our stat sheet, and like Oregon, they have 13 threes or 12 threes or probably double-figure threes. We're probably not going to win the game. On the other side, we have to make threes, too. Yeah. We haven't shot the ball well in league, so we need to take away the three-point line, and guys got to make shots today.
Yeah, remember the game, of course, 2 years ago in here. It was a little bit of an undermanned USC team and certainly an underdog USC team, and it was the three-point line that was the difference. Shaquan Aaron had the game of his career, but a lot of guys shot it well that night, and that three-point line can be the great equalizer.
Yeah, I think I was on the broadcast for that, and I think I said the same exact thing, and at that time they were near the top of the country in terms of 3 points
made.
Yes,
they were maybe the best three-point shooting team in the country with Lonzo dishing everything out.
Yeah. I don't remember what it was, but that was a focus for us. And it's the same thing, not because of this team, but because that's been a deficiency of our team, and we just got to do a better job of it. And then we have to make shots. It's hard to win games when you're making four or five threes a game and you're just not shooting the ball well. At some point, shooters have to shoot, players have to make plays. And for us to win, we got to do that. So the three-point line, I think, will be a telling tale of all of that.
All right, Coach Capco's going to go get suited up now. Go to work, USC, UCLA. Next up on Trojans Live, we've got a Trojan great in the house. Desmond Farmer knows all about this game. Coming up on ESPN LA 710.